Saying with the second magnetic field forming in the outer solar system, we're going to have more landslides, more sinkholes opening, more mud volcanoes, and we're not going to be able to grow crops as efficiently as the jet streams go further out of their regular flows for the next 3 years. We're going to get more and more control, not less. They're deluding you if you think you're going to get less control. From this point forward, it's going to be more stringent, more iron fist, more lockdown, more squeezed, more control. And I am saying that it's all about the food, the amount of food. So they're going to put the world on rations, but governments are going to continue to take the excess that we would have consumed for themselves for their continuity plans, leaving us out. So let's say there's 100 tons. We'll use the word 100 and 100 tons, and 50 was for the public and 50 was for government and military. Well, now they realize there's something really huge on the horizon coming in 2024. October is when you're looking. October 2024 is going to be the apex of this magnetic coupling, the most interaction with Earth. And after we come through October of 2024, it'll start to dissipate rather quickly because, you know, it's like that magnetism. Like if you're a kid and you had two magnets on a table, they instantly slam together. Well, it'll be just as instant when that magnetic field uncouples. So it'll just unlock pretty quickly. But during that interim time, with the changes that are coming, are going to be so vast. I mean, these earth changes that you thought were not possible in the wildest dreams are going to be possible. And the governments are going to want more control because they're going to want more control over your behavior because you're going to be scared and you're going to be uncontrollable. So they want to control you before you're uncontrollable. You're going to be hungry, which is the worst thing for societies because we've seen through history when people are hungry, they're uncontrollable. So they're going to want to control you before you can even get uncontrollable there. But then they're going to want to control the availability of food and the access to food. So they're going to control you there. And it's all based on the food. Everything's about the food from this point forward. And the second magnetic field forming in the outer solar system with Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. Now, if I'm anywhere close to being correct, you can call me out on it. I'm going to say there's going to be a massive planetary atmosphere disturbance on Uranus around late April or May of this year. Because you got to go back into May of 2020, Pluto's atmosphere collapsed. And then December of 2020, Neptune's atmosphere reversed. Now, the next planet in on, if you're looking at a Taurus loop, is going to be Uranus. And it's already starting to show atmospheric anomalies. So if that one goes, then for sure, it's just going to go Saturn, Jupiter, Mars, Earth. So that gives us till 2023, because these are on like about a roughly a six-month pattern of the next planet in the solar system experiencing atmospheric anomalies. Because I don't know what would happen to our, we couldn't literally grow food if our planet's atmosphere compressed or expanded or reversed the ability for us as a planetary society to continue to grow food would be nil for those years until we figured out where the new systems are setting up, how long, how dense, how intense, how deep, how ferocious it would be. And can you imagine trying to control a populace at that time? You literally couldn't. Well, this is where we're heading to within 3 years. So you can start to see lockstep how intense it's getting. It's matching with this anomaly that's coming through our solar system. And then the last thing is going to really freak people out is the blue comet that's coming through on the winter solstice of 2022. So that'll be another one. It's this big comet, Pan-STARRS K2 2017 C. Was the furthest out interacting.
How often does that circle around?
It doesn't. It's the first time it's ever been in our solar system, but it's blue. And it was the furthest out ever energetically interacting with the sun. That's how they spotted it so long ago. It's the furthest distance out ever to interact with the sun as a comet. Apparently, it's going to be as bright as the full moon during the day. And then in the evening, it's going to take up a percentage of the sky. But it's blue, like the blue star Kachina with the Hopi legends. So that's going to send people off their rockers too a couple of years before this 2024 alignment gets here. And it's all.
How big is this comet?
Nobody knows yet. Really, they haven't gotten that close to look at it. But the coma is already, this is 2 months ago, it was at least 10 degrees of arc across the sky. And that's still out past Saturn, way back out there, right around Uranus or something coming in. 10 degrees of arc that far out. When it gets here, it's going to be like 40 degrees of arc covering the sky. Like the halo is going to be just massive in the sky. Like I said, whoever remembers do you remember seeing Hail Bop in the sky up there with the blue and white one back in the 90s?
Yeah.
That's going to be a pinprick comparatively to how large this one is and what we're going to see.
This is not going to be a close call. I mean, in terms of getting into
orbit. No, it'll be right out at the boundary of Mars. It's going to be right around the orbit of Mars coming through.
Yeah, so it's going if it's having effects on the sun, then that's going to definitely have effects on Earth. And not only that, the effects on the sun is going to affect the Earth. And so it's going to be like this not just a coupling, it's going to be it's like a tri-coupling.
And then add the extra increasing magnetic field with the four gas giants out there, and then you get your fourth variable there that not a lot of people are taking into consideration.
You know, and it's interesting because a lot of people that are kind of, I would call them sensitive, their psyche is sensitive to things. A lot of them are sensing that they're feeling a shake. They're feeling the ground losing gravity or losing its foundation. And I'll tell you, that's something that would describe this kind of event that you're talking about. You know, there's this, the Earth's, the actual gravitational foundation is being disrupted.
Now, that could be a good thing too. Maybe our magnetic resonance in our brains and the hemispheres need to go to some reset level, and then we can start again with much more awareness. Then we can kick this darkness off for another 1,000 years. Mm-hmm. So don't look at it as doom and gloom. Look at it as perhaps the releasing mechanism that we can exist in a different vibration where we could see the evil for what it is, and everybody sees it so clearly that it's no longer accepted. I don't care what religion you're in, what political party you're in, what your socioeconomic strata is, whether you're male or female, it wouldn't matter. That it would be so all apparent that we would exist in a different vibration frequency. But I think to retune the frequency, the magnetic field needs to either collapse or get coupled with another magnetic field or get the resonance like you're talking about to almost a nil point and then reset before we can get into the different frequency. So for me, I'm looking at it as the possible thing that'll get us out of this, because something on like the creation level that will get us out of this, not anything on this human, like third dimensional level. It's going to take something different. And maybe the resetting of the magnetic field on a different vibrational frequency, like a radio station would tune into a different station. And instead of being on 105.8, we suddenly go into 16.1 or 106.1 is where you got retuned to. You know, something like this. I'm very hopeful for this time. I know it's going to be tumultuous and unfathomable and unbelievable. And I'm really looking forward to the changes because I know what I'm going to be looking for in the skies with plasma displays and, you know, sinkholes and kind of mud floods and all these kind of incredible things. But it's just verifying that these changes are here. And if you can just hold on until, I'm going to say October of 2024, everything you understood in terms of the way the Earth worked and the way society was functioned and set up, it's going to change in an instant. And it'll go back to something more harmonious, in tune again. And that's what I'm hoping with this double coupling magnetic field out there is going to do that, reset us, reset the world, reset society, reset everything into a new frequency.